In the last video, I showed you how to execute a script inside your own map, and I also showed some basic functions. In this video, I'm going to introduce you to concepts like player controller and player pawn, which will be your foundational building mods. First, we need to differentiate player controller and player pawn. You can think of player controller as the brain or the soul of your character. It does not contain any information such as your view angles, position, and etc. because it doesn't exist in the physical game world. Then there's player pawn, which is your physical body. It has all the physical information I mentioned earlier. Now let's go through some examples to get a better understanding of their difference. Now we are going to get the player controller. To do that, we're going to create a variable called player controller, which would be equal to instance get player controller. This needs an argument of an integer, as you can see here. And this slot represents your ID, which you can find from the console. It's probably zero, yeah, because you are the only real player in this current game. So we are going to type in zero. It still works. As you can see, the test text still appears on the left corner. I will reduce the duration to 0.01. Now let's take a look at player controller class. It extends entity, but as I explained earlier, since it doesn't have the physical properties of a player in the physical game world, you can't access these, where are they? Like get I position, it will return an error. I will show you in a second. Let's say we want to debug our I position. I will shift it right a little bit. And I will say player controller dot get I position. This should be correct. After I did that, I will save. And as you are going to see, the test text disappeared. The reason is that it gave us an error. Where is it? Exception during CS script callback thing. Method entity get I position invoked with incorrect this value. The reason is it doesn't have the position since it doesn't exist in the world. So we need to get the player pawn for that. To get the player pawn, let's create another variable called player pawn, and we will use not instance player controller dot get player pawn. Let me check if it's correct. Player controller, I get player pawn, which will return player pawn. And after that, now we can change this one to player pawn. Since player pawn, where is it? Player pawn extends base model entity, and base model entity extends entity. It has the same function, but now it won't return you an error. It will work fine. It says object. We need to come. Okay. Since this is a vector object, it showed up as an object, as you can see on the top left corner. We can write the x value of that. Yeah, now it works. As I move, that number changes in the top left corner. Yeah, our x axis is on this axis. As you can see, you can also get the view angles. Which is this. But this will return an error because angles are not stored in vectors, they are stored in angles. Q angle, let's go to Q angle definition here. vector has x, y, and z, but qangle has pitch, yaw, and roll instead. So we are going to read it as pitch, and you can see it changes from minus 89 to 89. You can also use the player pawn to get the active weapon that the player is currently holding. You can do that by saying, actually let me create another variable, active weapon, which would be player pawn dot get active weapon. Then this will return CS weapon ways or undefined. I'm not currently doing like error checks, but you can do that like if active weapon is not undefined. You can use something like that in order to continue your code, but I'm not doing that right now in order to keep things simple. Let's go to CS weapon bases definition, which is here. It has getData function, which will return CS weapon data. Where is CS weapon data? I can see it. It's here, right below it. Then we can get its name. So we can say dot get, what is weapon get data. Then this object will be an instance of CS weapon data. Then in here we can just say active weapon dot get name. This should return our current weapon. Yeah, weapon knife T. I will set this to an empty string. Weapon knife T, weapon Glock. If we give ourselves weapon AWP, it will be weapon AWP. You can use it like that. That's it for this video. I hope you liked it. I'm going slowly, but I have to go slowly in order for you to understand. If you have any suggestions, let me know in the comments. Or you can email me, I don't know. Or message me on somewhere. You can find me. Me Fanboy isn't a common nickname. So, thank you for watching.